Donald Duck is one of Disney's most popular characters of all time. He's the grouchy, temperamental antithesis of the innocent and cheerful Mickey Mouse. The hot-headed troublemaker whose antics won over audience acclaim during wartime, just as Mickey's was rapidly fading away. In fact, over time, Donald would go on to make more theatrical appearances than Mickey himself. In 2019, Donald Duck turns 85 years old, and in his 8.5 decades of existence, his look, design, and even personality have evolved drastically through a variety of cycles, along with changing animation styles and audience expectations. While Donald's design may not have changed as drastically as Mickey's, it would alter close to 20 times across his 85 years of existence in a slow yet often subtle evolution. In this video, I will trace the evolution of Donald Duck right from his first screen appearance in 1934 to today in 2019. To do so, we will look at the most drastic and important changes prevalent across more than 20 classic shorts and series. In this edition of Explaining Disney. While the Walt Disney Company officially recognizes Donald's birth year as 1934, the year he first appeared on the screen, Donald's origins might actually date back 3 years earlier. The very first appearance of a Donald Duck was in a 1931 Disney storybook, The Adventures of Mickey Mouse, the very first Disney book printed for retail sale. In this book, Donald is listed amongst a cattle call of Mickey's barnyard friends and even appears on the back cover. In this illustration, we get a fairly primitive looking Donald. Not only does he resemble an actual duck instead of the anthropomorphized humanoid he would later evolve into, but he appears in vastly different clothing than that which has become synonymous with him. In this, Donald wears green and not blue, and even wears pants for one of the only times in his history. Disney would debut Donald Duck in a theatrical short. However, his first appearance would not be in a Mickey short, but in a silly symphony called The Wise Little Hen, an adaptation of the classic tale The Little Red Hen. In this, we see Donald's earliest humanoid design, the evolutionary leap between the actual duck Donald and the iconic Donald we all know and love. In The Wise Little Hen, Donald appears in his iconic sailor outfit, but as you can see in this early design, he's drawn with buttons on his shirt, a white hat with blue brim, and a black bow tie. While his hat wouldn't change color in the shorts for 5 years and his bow tie for 65, early promotional art and comic strips would depict him wearing a blue hat with a black brim and a red bow tie. In these early appearances, you'll also note Donald's elongated neck and bill, as well as his bulbous circular body, giving him an unrealistic, almost frightening appearance. Unlike Mickey 6 years earlier, Donald would make his debut appearance in colour, as the Silly Symphonies were at this point being produced as colour shorts. Donald would somewhat devolve for a small number of appearances, however, as he appeared in black and white in 3 Mickey Mouse shorts, as the Mickeys weren't yet being produced in colour at the time of their production. In both Orphans Benefit and Mickey's Service Station, a few changes were made to Donald's appearance, but mainly ones that would help the character's details appear more noticeable in the black and white format. Donald's hat would be shaded grey, suggesting a colour hat despite his white hat in the previous short, and his bow tie was left white despite his black bow tie in the previous short. The strangest choice for this black and white Donald, however, would be his black legs and feet. Orphans Benefit also saw the first of Donald's many iconic temper tantrums. In The Dognapper, Donald would appear in this same design, but was given a story-inspired costume change. However, we are not going to spend time discussing every single one of Donald's different themed costumes over the years, because we would be here all day. The following year, in 1935, Donald would once again appear in colour in the very first colour Mickey Mouse short, The Band Concert. In this, Donald would go back to his first design, white hat, black bow tie, and would strangely be given blue eyes for the first time. Donald's eyes would switch back to white for the majority of his shorts, but would occasionally be coloured blue in the odd short every now and then. Other than his oddly changing eye colour, Donald would remain in this design over the course of another 6 Mickey shorts until mid-1936, when Mickey's Grand Opera marked the final appearance of Donald's original form. By 1936's Moving Day, Mickey Mouse had undergone his own radical redesign, one which would become the standard Mickey design going forward. Where he previously had an asymmetrical design, he now had a pear-shaped body, which allowed animators to employ squash and stretch animation techniques, giving him the ability to move more freely and realistically, as if he had weight and could abide by the rules of gravity. Because Mickey, Disney's number one star of the era, had undergone such a fundamental change, everyone around him had to as well. In Moving Day, following Mickey's suit, Donald was debuted in a new design. Much like Mickey, Donald's body also changed from being a big round circle to a more duck-like pear-shaped body, while his bill was shortened, flattened, and made a little more realistic. Thanks to the new design and recent employment of squash and stretch techniques, where Donald was once a rigid, squawky duck, he was now given the first signs of an attitude, as he was able to be drawn in new, flexible positions and in a more emotive range of expressions and bodily movements, giving him a whole new life, personality, and realism. Later in the same year, Donald would appear in the very first of what these days would be known as a backdoor pilot, an episode of a series designed as the segue into a separate spin-off series. 1936's Donald and Pluto was the very first Mickey Mouse short not to include Mickey Mouse as a character, and instead served to highlight Donald's character at a time where his fame was growing in audiences. The short teamed him up with Mickey's faithful pup Pluto, and debuted yet another new design by animator Fred Spencer. Spencer's new design gave Donald an even shorter bill, a shorter neck, rounder feet, and an even slimmer body. The following year, 1937, Donald appeared in yet another Mickey-less Mickey short, Don Donald, Donald's second backdoor pilot, which marked the first short to feature Donald as the main character. The short is also notable for the first appearance of Daisy Duck, though she would be called Donna Duck here. With this short and Donald and Pluto, Walt and his animators were building the groundwork for Donald's own series and gauging if one would be a hit with audiences. Their experiment obviously paid off, because later that year, the first Donald Duck short, Donald's Ostrich, debuted. Here, Donald's design would remain the same, but he would wear yet another slightly altered themed costume. Donald remained in the same design for 25 more shorts, including four Mickeys, when once again a shift in animation styles in the late 1930s brought on Donald's most iconic evolution. By 1939, Donald Duck had well and truly won over audience affection. In that year alone, Disney released 8 Donald shorts and only 4 Mickey shorts. Despite Donald's rocketing popularity, Mickey was still the studio's star child and always paved the way for the entire cast of Disney characters. That year, animator Fred Moore, the studio's Mickey specialist who had originally brought squash and stretch techniques to the studio, gave Mickey yet another modern redesign, which made him cuter, more expressive, more human, and more attractive to audiences. Following the leader of the pack, Donald also found himself conforming to the new Fred Moore character style. Much like Mickey, he was given more realistic features, including a slightly larger, more pronounced head, and wider, more realistic eyes. His costume also changed for perpetuity as well. Just like in the comic strips, his blue hat finally debuted in the shorts. His shirt collar also became a darker shade of blue, though over future shorts, his collar would change from dark to light. As Moore's design became the standard for Mickey's modern design, the newly designed Donald also became iconic of the character. Throughout the height of World War II, the temperamental troublemaker that he was, Donald became the figurehead for Disney's propaganda and wartime shorts, appealing to national pride in a gung-ho manner that the innocent childlike Mickey never could. Disney put Mickey Mouse into retirement for a number of years and slowed down production on his shorts for most of the 1940s. Donald, on the other hand, was absolutely flourishing. In 1945 alone, the final year of the war, Disney released 8 Donald shorts, and still hiding him in a bunker somewhere, released absolutely no Mickey shorts. Though he led the cavalry as the figurehead for Disney's wartime efforts, Donald would also become a spokesperson for peace in Disney's 2 South America Good Neighbor program films, Saludos Amigos in 1942 and The 3 Caballeros in 1944, reminding the world that he wasn't all temper tantrums and short fuses, but lovable and caring as well. Donald wouldn't evolve all that much during wartime, but the year after, in the 1946 short Donald's Double Trouble, the button on his shirts were removed. After this, Donald's appearance was not altered drastically for the remainder of his classic short series. While Mickey would only appear in 8 more shorts after the war, with his final short releasing in 1953, Donald would appear in 72, with his shorts continuing until 1960, only coming to an end after the sudden passing of Walt Disney. Donald wouldn't appear in theatrical animation throughout the 1960s, though he would often be used in a series of educational films and commercials for Disney, where the hybrid Spencer-Moore character style would continue to be used. Donald would be put in moratorium at the Disney studio throughout the 1970s, along with Mickey, who'd been there since the mid-1950s. Neither of them would appear again in theatrical animation until 1983's Mickey's Christmas Carol, where once again they would continue to be used in their Spencer and Moore design, much as they did in 1990's The Prince and the Pauper, 1999's Fantasia 2000, and a series of television shows. In DuckTales, first debuting in 1987, Donald never appears in his iconic sailor suit, though opting for a navy uniform, once again utilizing a white hat and black scarf. In Quack Pack, first debuting in 1996, he rarely appeared in any kind of maritime outfit, instead wearing a blue Hawaiian shirt for most of the series. In Mickey Mouse Works, debuting in 1999, Donald would once again appear in his sailor uniform, with one small change. After so many years, he finally appeared with his red bow tie on the screen, a design element which, once again, had been utilized in comics and marketing materials since the 1930s. The red bow tie and Spencer Moore style would also influence Donald's later CG appearances in 3D animated productions, such as 2004's Mickey's Twice Upon a Christmas and Mickey Mouse Clubhouse, which premiered in 2006. In more recent years, Donald has appeared in a more stylized form, in the later series of Mickey Mouse Disney Channel cartoon shorts by Paul Rudish. Donald's appearance in this series incorporates many eras of his design. He has characteristics of the Fred Spencer and Fred Moore eras, he sports his red bow tie, blue hat, and his buttons even make a comeback. His blue eyes from the earlier shorts are back, and for the very first time they appear as pie eyes, an animation technique used in the black and white era and outdated well before Donald ever made his first appearance on the screen. In 2017, however, Donald returned to his most iconic design in the DuckTales revival series. While he has worn his iconic blue uniform very briefly, he opts for a black one, similar to that seen in the classic DuckTales comics for a majority of the episodes. Though in 2018's Legend of the Three Caballeros series, Donald's blue suit makes its comeback, complete with classic black tie and buttons. Just as with Mickey, Donald has come full circle, and as with everything, what's old is new again, and it's clear that the Donald we all know and love ain't going away anytime soon. And with that, it's over to you guys out there. I want to know, what is your favourite Donald Duck appearance over the last 85 years? Fire away in the comments below and let me know your thoughts. If this is your first time viewing one of my videos, you like what you've seen, you'd like to see more like this in the future, then please don't forget to hit that big old subscribe button up on your screen right now, and also hit that like button down below if you're feeling extra generous. Also, don't forget to check out my many social media accounts, and please consider supporting me over on Patreon. Thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you have a wonderful day.